To you by Jif, the peanut butter with great peanut smell, great peanut taste, great peanut quality. And now let's all play What's My Line? And now, live from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, Columbia University's gift to television, the beautiful and talented Miss Sue Oakland.
Television owes a large debt to the imagination and creative energy of the man on my left, the great Mark Goodson.
Thank you. For those of you who have no color television sets, Miss Carter's wearing a beautiful green dress.
Miss Oakland.
Miss Oakland. Believe it or not, we only have 8 more shows to go on What's My Line. After nearly 18 years, it seems incredible, but all good things come to an end. So I have kind of a sentimental reason for being here, because it's my last chance to introduce on the air a co-worker of nearly 18 years, a great friend, Arlene Francis.
And now, our Random House publisher, whose amusing column, Try and Stop Me, is read in 600 newspapers around the world, and we have him for our very own for 8 more weeks anyway. Mr. Bennett, sir.
Well, if you notice that John Daly's always mellifluent voice is even more resonant than ever tonight, it's because he's boning up for that prestigious job as head of Voice of America, which will be starting right after Labor Day. So he is silver-tongued John Charles Daly.
Thank you. Miss Sue, it's nice to have you back with us. And
thank
boss,
you.
Nice to see you there.
Nice to see you, John.
And there was a nice little speech you made about Arlene. And Arlene and Bennett and I have been together now the better part of, 17 and a half years with Mark. And we're all getting nostalgic as the days and the weeks go by. But that does not stop us from getting occupations which will give the four of you the nip-ups in the next half hour. We'll also have a mystery guest before our friends, a famous mystery guest, before our friends a little bit later in the program. But right now, let's meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? John and Frank McGuire. Right, sir? Good. Well, Mrs. McGuire, may I ask where you're from?
Originally from Glasgow, Scotland. Now residing in Victoria, Canada.
Victoria, Canada, and originally from Glasgow.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, well, it's nice to have you with us. May I present you both to the panel? The Masters McGuire, and now if you'll come over here, gentlemen, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. right. Panel, we can tell you that the Messrs. McGuire are self-employed and deal in a product, and we'll begin things with Arlene Francis.
Thank you, John. Is it a useful product?
Yes.
Do you suppose any on the panel might own such a product?
No.
No, I wouldn't think so. 1 down and 9 to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. McGuire, your backs were turned to us, so I didn't hear where you came from. Did you say Glasgow?
Originally from Glasgow, presently now operating in Victoria in British Columbia in Canada.
In British Columbia. Is the product in which you are dealing, is it or has it ever been alive?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it alive while you're dealing with it?
Yes. Yes.
Is it an animal?
Yes.
Is it a four-legged animal?
No.
No. 2 down and 8 to go. Sue.
Have we ruled out the possibility of it being a human animal?
Has not been ruled out.
How can I phrase this so that I can get the maximum out of it? Is it a human animal?
You got the maximum.
I got the minimum.
You got the maximum. Okay. That's 3 down and 7 to go. Mark.
It's an animal, but it's not four-legged. Is it, an animal which is found on land as opposed to water?
No.
That takes care of that thing.
4 down and 6 to go. Arlie.
It is therefore a sea animal, hmm?
Yes.
Very large?
Yes, sometimes.
Grows, does it? Yes. are its parts ever edible?
Yes. Yes.
Is it in the mammal family rather than the fish family?
No.
Nope. 5 down and 5 to go, Mr. Sir.
In British Columbia, they have some wonderful salmon up there. Might it be the salmon family that you're dealing with?
No.
Nope. 6 down and 4 to go. Sue Oakland.
Now, when we say animal, that's a very large category. That means living. Is that right, John?
Right.
Because a fish is considered animal on this program?
Well, an animal, vegetable, yes. Mineral,
yes,
it would be,
right.
Yes.
It's a fish of some kind, is it?
Well, we'd say in a very general way it belongs to that species, yes.
I mean, as opposed to a crustacean or some other...
No, just in the very general sense. If you want to get specifically to crustaceans and other elements and specific elements of
Mollusks
the fish family,
and like
why,
that.
We'd be glad to have you ask the question.
But you're now incorporating into the fish category,
well, animals,
all of these things.
The whole mess. I mean, all these things.
Now, does this have anything on it that's hard?
Yes.
Does it have what might be termed a shell of some kind?
Yes.
It could be in a very general way a game, yes.
Yes. But then I gather from your tone that it's not a crustacean or lobster or a clam, something that is obviously a shell kind of fish.
Yeah, I would say it's not as obvious in this case,
yes,
as it is in other cases where one can't shell out as often as one would like to.
Does this have scales, then? Is that what you would be considering the hard part?
No.
No scales. Actually, hasn't got a weight problem. That's 7 down and 3 to go. Mr. Goodson.
This fish, or whatever it is it, have they come pretty sizable? Do they ever weigh up to 100 pounds?
Yes.
They do? Both of you fellows work in the same place?
Yes.
Yeah. Do you train or catch this particular kind of fish?
Yes.
Is it something like a turtle?
No.
That's 8 down and 2 to go. Arlene.
I was sure that's what it was.
I was right on the back of that turtle.
Yeah.
Now remember, we've determined that the shell area has not to do with anything that is usual or crustaceous.
However, you also say it has no scales. I mean, some fish.
Right.
It's got no scales, it's got no shells.
Now you're getting closer every minute, Arlene.
Is it ever very small?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Would it be considered a soft shell in any way?
Well, to the degree that a shell is there, we'd have to agree that it has softness
like a soft shell crab.
Well, I wouldn't say it would be exactly like a soft-shell crab. We're assuming that what structure there is there may have been at one time hard-shell, now has to be generally described as being in the shell area, and we would be very happy, as I think you would be,
if we got away from the
shell.
does it
ever get into the sand?
No.
Rather than stay in the sea?
No. Doesn't like sand, as a matter of fact.
You both come from Scotland. We can eliminate the Loch Ness Monster, I take it.
Minster, too. You can get rid of the Minster.
Does this object that you deal with ever croak?
No. A lot of people do croak when they see one, though.
Really?
I'm scared to death of them.
Is it a snake?
No, I think probably...
An eel?
No, an eel has no shell.
It's
the area that we're talking about that threw you off. Actually, I didn't know it,
but
there
are
octopuses up there.
I was thinking of octopus, but where is the shell on the octopus?
Well, it's an
old... They're all so soft.
It's in the beak. It's an old... Probably had a big shell at one time, which is why I tried to get you away from shells as much as I could.
It's that old shell game again.
The old shell game. But actually, John and Frank go out in scuba gear and go down to the lair of the octopus, which they know and which they will not reveal specifically.
I'm happy to hear.
And what is it, you take copper sulfate?
Yes.
And they squirt copper sulfate at them, which irritates the daylights out of an octopus, would, I'm sure, and the one of you, too. And then the octopus gets out, and preferably you get them in sand where they can't use the suction cups. Then they wrestle them up to the surface.
And do they squirt back at you?
Yes.
Ink.
Ink?
How big is the big octopus?
Oh,
they go real big, 150 pounds, yeah. 22 feet
I always think of the nearsighted octopus that fell in love with a Scotch bagpipe. One of the...
Oh, yeah. We've had that one.
The Messrs. McGuire's have heard that one. Yeah. They came from Glasgow, you know? Well, it's a wonderfully interesting occupation. Thank you both for coming down to see us. Nice to see you. Another contestant for you in just a moment after this word.
It was one of the most unconventional settings for a sitcom ever, but it didn't take long for it to become a true TV classic. Hogan's Heroes featured some of the greatest comic characters in television history. Colonel Hogan.
Just where do you think we might have hidden a tiger tank?
Colonel Klink.
The man who said that will take two steps forward.
Sergeant Schultz.
Oh. You ought to fix the hole in the ground. Someone might fall in and hurt himself.
Corporal Newkirk.
Frohlein is liberty.
And it's now available exclusively from Columbia House. Hogan's Heroes, the collector's edition on DVD. Join all the memorable characters of Stalag 13, the World War II POW camp from which no one had ever escaped.
You know our proud boast, no one has ever escaped from Stalag 13.
Or so Colonel Klink thought.
Oh, I see nothing. I was not here. I did not even get up this morning.
Colonel Klink, you're an evil man.
Yes, I am. And it makes me feel good all over.
Each episode is presented in chronological order, full length. Plus, get added bonuses like production notes and episode trivia.
Request permission to fall flat on my face if necessary.
Call right now for complete series details and get the first DVD in the Hogan's Hero series for just $9.95 plus shipping and processing. 6 episodes in all, plus the rarely seen black and white pilot. Then, every 4 to 6 weeks, we'll send you 2 more DVDs to preview at regular prices.
Shut up and listen. Yes, sir, shut up and listen.
There's no club to join. Cancel any time. Call right now and get the next DVD in the series absolutely free. That's 2 DVDs for just $9.95 plus shipping and processing. 13 episodes in all. Not available in stores. Buy 1 DVD for $9.95. Get the next one free. Only from Columbia House. Call right now for details.
Dismissed.
4 teams have been eliminated, 4 teams remain.
First, certified public assassins play Ink Incorporated.
CPAs are just picking Ink apart.
Then, Barbell Mafia plays Armed Response. Extreme Dodgeball Semifinals, Tuesdays at 10 on GSN.
And now to meet our second challenger, will you sign in after you have entered? Please. Sandy? Driggin, right, ma'am? All right. Is it
Miss or Mrs. Triggin?
It's Miss.
Miss Triggin, and where are you from?
Forest Hills, New York.
Forest Hills, New York. And you won't mind if I announce that you're going to enter your senior year at the University of Michigan.
No,
I'd
love
it. September. So we're talking about really a summer occupation. May I now, Miss Triggin, present the panel? And if you come over here, please, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what you're like. Panel, we can tell you that Miss Driggin is salaried and deals in a product, and we'll begin things with, bedded surf.
Well, now that we find out, Miss Driggin, that an octopus has a shell...
Don't fight City Hall, Bennett. Just go get the book.
Which I still doubt very much. Miss Driggin, the product that you deal in is one, I take it, that could be used by human beings?
Yes, sir.
Human beings of both sexes?
Yes.
Might it also be used by children?
Yes.
Is it a product that is consumable?
Yes, it is.
Is it taken into the mouth?
Yes, it is sometimes.
It is?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I would just say yes, it is, period.
Is it a solid rather than a liquid?
Hopefully.
It is a solid. Is it sometimes eaten cold and or warm? Can it be eaten both cold and warm?
I think so.
He can?
Mm-hmm.
No, wait a minute, minute. We gotta have a small cut. Miss Driggin wants to be fair, Bennett.
Yes, John.
And as the old shell game has it, you just gotta know. That's
I bet
one
it's
down
something
and
it melts and it's cold.
Well, now,
it melts when it's
back.
Warm, Bennett.
When it's cold, when it's warm. Sue?
Is it sweet?
Yes, it is.
Is it in the confection or dessert area?
Yes.
It could be considered so.
Is it sold at circuses and, kind of amusement parks and,
Yes, I think so.
It could be.
It could be.
Mm-hmm.
We got kind of a rise out of you at the word children. So, I mean, is it kind of oriented toward the younger set?
No, I don't think so. I think it can be.
I could have had some just before the show started.
Yeah, yes. I would have to give you a note on that, because while children would like it very much, it's not oriented specifically toward children. Adults get it. Yes, you did.
Oh,
sorry.
Yes.
That's 2 down and 8 to go, Mr. Goodson.
Is it served cold, basically?
I think so.
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
Is it chilled? I mean, is that kind of cold? Like ice cream is cold?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Well, is it a form of ice cream in some way, or ice?
Yes, it is.
You're nodding, John. I'm about to leap over the thing. Is it on a stick?
Yes.
Cotton candy? Is that what you're going to ask?
No. You're a popsicle thrower or something like that.
Popsicle thrower? No. That's 3 down and 7 to go, Miss Francis.
Are you a good humor girl?
Actually, I don't know. I have to ask you, are you the only good humor man who is a girl?
No, there are a few of us, but very limited number.
Do you have your own wagon?
Yes, I do.
Sandy drives a white good humor truck.
Where do you hang out, Sandy?
Lindenhurst.
Don't tell him. Don't. Well, my heavenly days, he's not in the office very much now. We can't have him hanging around Rego Park all the time. But has her own area, and you wear a blue jacket and...
And slacks and a cap.
And a blue cap.
And I ring the bells.
Any samples?
Not with me right now. It melts.
As we found out. And is entering... What is your course at Michigan?
I'm a pre-med student, and I'm majoring in economics. I hope to go to medical school after I graduate, which is next April.
Oh, wonderful. Congratulations to you and good humor for having such a charming day. We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, this message.
I'm Matthew Lesko, and my new book will tell you how to tell bill collectors to go shove it! My new book shows you 4,000 government programs that you can use to pay your bills and get out of debt forever! Get $2,000 to pay your rent or mortgage. Or $600 to pay your phone bill. Or even $7,000 to pay your credit card bills. I've been researching government grants for over 25 years, and government officials don't even know about these programs. And you've never seen a book that's so easy to use. Here's a program to pay for your prescription drug bills, or a program to pay for your living expenses, or programs to pay for your housing bills, apartment bills, or even your student loans. Over 80% of the people in the United States, including millionaires, are eligible. Isn't it about time you get rid of your debt once and for all? If you don't use these programs, somebody else will. So call now and get free money to pay your bills.
Call 1-800-258-2999 now.
On Dog Eat Dog, the hunt is on.
Take a walk on the wild side.
Who will take home the prize and who will be left holding the bone?
You gotta be kidding me!
Dog Eat Dog, weeknights at 9 Eastern and Pacific, only on GSN, the network for games.
And now the special feature of our program, the appearance of the mystery challenger, for which the panel is always blindfolded. Blindfolds in place, panel.
Hold your breath. Yes.
Good. Will you enter, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Panel, in this case, we go to a different form of questioning, one question at a time, in turn moving clockwise, and we'll begin things with Mark Goodson.
Thank you. Incidentally, John, you know, I've been trying desperately to peek through this mask to see if it's possible. It is impossible. It's very black in here. Is the mystery guest female, feminine?
Nope.
One down and nine to go, Miss Francis.
Are you in the motion picture world?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Sir.
Is there more than one mystery guest?
Yep. Sue?
I thought so. Either that or it had the longest name in show business. Now, is this what might be classified as a group, then?
Yep.
Mark?
Are there more than two of you?
Yep.
Arlene?
Are you a musical group?
You lose 2 points on that. That's four down and six to go, Mr. Sir.
Would you, by any chance, be a baseball aggregation?
That's five down and five to go, Sue.
Have we established the show business nature of the work that these people do?
I don't believe so.
Well, can we now establish that? Do you? Are you? Have you?
What?
In show business.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Mark?
I'd like to know how many there are in this group. They're all men. Hasn't it? Yes. May I assume that you're all men? Because I asked if there were.
Yep.
You're all men, right?
Yep.
Okay. Are you actors? Would you describe yourself as actors as opposed to singers?
Yep.
Arlene?
Yep.
They are actors, that's what we've found out, but they're not in the motion picture world. Are you television performers?
Yep, yep.
Dennis?
The echo in this place. Have you now or ever had anything to do with this panel in the past?
Yep. Nope. What
was that answer?
That was a yes, nope, nope. That should be crystal clear, Bennett. A yes, nope, nope. Sue?
Do you then comprise the cast of a specific television show?
Nope, nope.
8 down and 2 to go, Mr. Goodson.
Do you comprise the cast of something?
Yep, yep, nope.
Nope.
There was a nope in there, too.
Yeah. No, I would say the question was, do you comprise the cast of something?
As a unit, the three of them, or four of them.
Nope.
8 down and 2 to go, Miss Francis.
Is it possible that some do and some don't in that outfit?
Ain't that always true?
What?
Sounds like a kettle of wild wool.
9 down and 1 to go, Mr. Sir.
Are you all employees or associates of Goodson Todman?
Yep.
It's Frank Heller.
It's Frank Heller and all the people backstage in this show.
No, let's come down and no more to go. You may unmask and say hello to Bud Collier of To Tell the Truth, Alan Ludden of Password, Ed McMahon of Snap Judgment, and Gene Rayburn of Match Game. Presenting you all to Mr. Goodson.
I want to thank all of you men for coming here and disgracing us.
You almost had it.
No, not anywhere near.
Good. I'm glad to see you.
Like a bunch of kennel dogs.
Just keep those checks coming.
Jeannie
and I love to see them every week. We got around the acting thing because when it was asked, you got, yep, nope, nope. Actually, Alan does do summer stock, as you know, and I think also
I do too.
Ed's done it, but you haven't done summer stock yet.
No.
So Dirty should have been one of. This picture isn't really complete yet, with everybody's kind permission. Johnny Olsen, you come over here.
Yeah.
Explain, of course, you've all seen Johnny with us before, but Johnny also is associated with three of the four programs represented here. Which one are you not?
I couldn't make Alan's because they were conflicting.
But on To Tell the Truth, on Snap Judgment, and on Match Game, Johnny's part of that too. He's
Johnny will warm up three people on a corner. He just sees three. Come on, I'm Johnny Olsen. Let's hear it.
He's the king of it.
Yeah, we're going to run him for something sooner or later. Well, thank you, fellas. Good to see you all.
Thank you.
Nice to be here. Good to see you, Jim.
Okay, sir.
Good to see you. Don't give us a hug.
Hello, guys.
Fun. We rather thought that would give you some trouble, and I'm very glad that it did. But in spite of that, I must say you did well. You performed well. We can give you some congratulations, and we'll all be back after this word.
On the series finale of Average Joe Hawaii, it's the ultimate showdown. Personality.
I want to show the world that the average regular guy can get the girl.
Versus looks.
I hope she knows I'm very interested in her.
But as her passion grows stronger with two final dream dates.
It just blew me away.
It's a true dream come true.
Will the love of her life be destroyed by her secret?
I do have something in my past.
Average Joe Hawaii, the series finale, Wednesday night at 10 on GSN, the network for games. It's all come down to this on the season finale of Celebrity Blackjack. Only five remain. Only one celebrity will win $100,000 for charity. Celebrity Blackjack, Monday at 10, only on GSN, the network for games.
Four teams have been eliminated, four teams remain.
First, certified public assassins play Ink Incorporated.
CPAs are just picking Ink Inc. apart.
Then, Barbell Mafia plays Armed Response. Extreme Dodgeball Semifinals, Tuesdays at 10 on GSN.
Well, Miss Sue, again, it was nice to have you with us. Mark, hope you enjoyed
that. Thank you, John. It was fun.
Being at work, for a change. Arlene and Bennett, how's that? And good night, Miss Sue.
Good night. Good night, Mark.
Thank you, dear. Good night. Night, Arlene.
Hope you'll be on with us for another 10 or 12 shows,
yes,
Mark.
Yes, thank you.
Good night, Bennett.
Henry Morgan joins me in saying good night, John.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
I just wish he'd gone to Tilton School. He'd have been a much better man if he had. That's all I've got to say. And thanks to all of you for being with us on What's My Line.
What's My Line is a CBS television network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Todman. Miss Frances Gowan from Bonwit Color, Miss Oakland from Oscar De La Renta. This is Johnny Olsen speaking for What's My Line? What's My Line was brought to you tonight by Post Honeycomb. Now bite-sized, so it's crisper, crunchier, better than ever. New Post Honeycomb.
GSN.